today I'm going to show you how to make this 2-in-1 pouch. Let's get started. Before we start, I'm gonna show you the pouch. Looks like just single pouch, but there's two pocket inside. It attached. Well, actually, three pocket inside. Once you open the zipper like that, there's two obvious pocket. And in the middle, there's small pocket as well. The reason I made this, because my bag, daily bag, is always messy inside. I tried to organize, you know, everything inside, but, you know, too much stuff I carry, right? So, if I have a pouch like this in my bag, I can maybe organize a little bit better. That's the reason why I made this. Okay, so I made this very flat this time. But you can actually make gusset or kind of, you know, a carve. It's really up to you. But this time, I'm going to show you square one. Okay? Let's get prepared. Outer fabric 11 inch by 14. The top part 11 inch. The height is 14 inch. 11 by 14. One thing I want to tell you, the 11 inch side would be attached with zipper. Okay, so if you have a certain design, you know, so you have to think how to cut the fabric. And outer layer, I put really thin fusible on already. You need two pieces. And zipper 12 inch. And I also prepared inner layer, two pieces. Same size, no fusible, okay? 11 by 14, no fusible. And the tab for zipper, which is 2 by 3 inches. And you can see my description box for every material detail. Okay, so first of all, you have to draw a line on the fabric, the back side. Okay? Half inch from the top, you draw the line. Can you see the pink line? I already drew the line. And you fold it right on the line and use the iron to make it really crisp. The other side, you don't have to do that. Only where the zipper comes. Okay? Every four fabric, you have to do it, okay? Only one side, which is 11-inch side. Do you remember? 11-inch side comes to the zipper, but the other side, you don't need to, okay? And half inch from both side, you draw the line, okay? And 1 inch from the top with fold, okay? Just like that, the other side. 2 inch from side and 1 inch from top with fold. Every single one of them, you have to do it. Again, you stay fold and half inch from side and 1 inch from top. You draw the line like that. Every side. So 8 of them you have to do it. Okay? And now zipper. The top of the zipper. That's the right side and this is wrong side. Fold it like that and make it triangle and on the side you sew them like that. You don't really have to if you don't like it, but this looks much better later. Okay? So you better do it. Fold it like that and sew them. Just like that. Zipper top. First of all, you put the zipper like that and fold it inward and I use the iron and maybe half inch both ends, fold it and iron and you look my video carefully. This is how you do it. First of all, I just want to make a plan where you want to put the tag. Okay? Because you don't really want to sew on the metal part. So, I decide I'm going to sew there. Nothing underneath. There you go, like that. Okay? Then flip. Just like that. Then fold inward. Like that. And again, fold at the very bottom, half inch, then fold again. You can tuck the, you know, the top part in. That's actually what I did. And sew them around. Easy. That's the zipper tab. And now I want you to look at the zipper. That's a right side. And if you really look at that zipper carefully, there's a line in the middle. That line I am going to use. Okay? So watch carefully, please. Here's the folding line, which is half inch from top. And you place the zipper right side together and starting right on the half inch from the side. And again, you want to use the line on the zipper. Also, the folding line matches because you want to sew right on the both line, zipper line, the mid zipper line, and the folding line. Okay? So you have to use the pin to secure. Before you sew, make sure from the behind it's right on top or not. Also, you can't not sew first and last half inch. Okay? So you put the pin where to start and when to stop. Okay, so you get a saw right on the that line. And I just did. And here comes the inner layer. To be really honest with you, this is pretty much same as making, you know, regular pouch. I just want to make sure first half and last half inch you don't want to sew. Okay? And I'm actually using the fold line and the mid line on the zipper. That's the only difference. But, you know, this is just a basic, you know, zipper attachment. Okay? So, anyway, use the folding line. And the line you already saw, it's actually quite easy this time. And those two fabric has to be right side together. And that, you know, half inch line maybe you should secure them first because that'll be easier, right? And make sure you can't not sew those, you know, half inch side. One more thing I have to tell you, this is very important. In the middle of the inner fabric, you can't not sew. You have to leave about 4 inches opening because you have to turn inside out at the very end. Okay, so you sew first line there, then last line there. So you can't not sew first end half inch and the middle 4 inch. And I just did. Okay, that's the opening I just, you know, skipped. And here goes like that. You attached one side of the zipper. And now, the other side of the zipper, you do exactly same thing. Okay, first of all, I'm using the outside fabric. Again, don't forget about the half inch start and half inch end. You can't not sew. You do exactly same method. And please don't forget about the 4 inches opening for the back side. I'm just showing you the, I just secured the fabric with the pin. Okay? And you have to make sure the fabric has to be right side together. Then I'm done both zipper. There you go. This is again pretty much basic zipper technique. Now you wanna sew both end. Okay? So one side you roll up like that. And maybe use the clip to secure them. Then you sandwich them. One with the outer layer and the other one is inner layer, right side together. In the middle of those two fabric, there's the other side of the two fabric rolled up. Okay? Just like that. Okay? The rolled up, that's because, you know, I don't want to, you know, accidentally sew them, right? So use pin to secure them and half inch seam allowance you just sew just across, just like that. And you open the seam, maybe use the iron to make it crisp. You can do that later, okay? Because you have to do the other side as well. You flip inside out, then the one you just saw, you rolled up. Okay, you can actually iron later. And the other side, sandwich those, you know, fabric, right side together, outer and inner fabric, just like that. Okay? And then half inch seam allowance, sew across. And there you go. Now you open the seam allowance, iron really, really well, make it really crisp. Then you have to top stitch, but only bottom part, not the zipper side. Both end, you can do top stitch, not the zipper part, okay? The key point is use the iron and make it really crisp. There you go. Now, let's make inside pocket, okay? The small pocket I showed you at the very beginning, And here's the measurement. 2.5 inch from the side. Okay? 2.5 inch. Draw the line. And the other side, same thing, 2.5. I actually made the first one before this, and I took the bigger inside pocket and this one. And I thought about it, do I really need the bigger pocket like that? You know, the in the middle right there. And my answer was no. Maybe I'm gonna put small thing there. So, you know, this time I'm gonna make very small pocket. Okay, so 2.5 inch from both sides. Draw two lines. Then 3 inches from the top. Actually, from the bottom, which means no zipper. Okay, but, you know, as you can see, the top is top. So anyway, 3 inch from the top, you draw the line. So there's the rectangle, right? But the line is only 3, and you sew them there, two fabric together, okay? Then make it, you know, pocket. Obviously, top part you're not going to sew because it's going to be pocket, right? You need opening. So use the clip or pin to secure those two, the outer layer right side together. So now you're facing the inner fabric. The red fabric is the outer fabric for me. Okay, so I am using the pin to secure and make sure all the alignments are good. One more thing I just want to mention about the pocket. If you want to make the bigger pocket, the bottom line goes to the 1 inch line from the top, just like that. So the pouch size is pretty much that size. So if you want to make the bigger pocket, fine, but make sure you have to draw a line with that size. Okay, if it's too big, you might have to sew both sides, right? So you gotta be very careful. Now I sew those pink line I just drew. And then finally, I made the pocket. Then, let's sew on the side. Again, the bottom goes to 1 inch line like that later. Okay, not now. You have to actually prepare one more thing before you have to do, which is you see the pocket right there. And there's a flip wing for both sides, right? So you fold it like that inward and use the clip to secure that the other side too. And open the zipper wide open like that. And fold zipper tail and all that, just the one side of the zipper fabric like that, and rolled up. Then maybe you need to use one more clip to secure. There you go. Then now you have to turn inside out. But you gotta watch my video carefully here. That part attached the pocket. So this side, the zipper side, You put the hand in, then just flip. Okay, this is a little bit tricky part. So grab the 11-inch side with the zipper and just make sure, you know, has to kind of flatten as much as possible, like that. It's a little bit tricky here, but please take your time. And that bottom part you just saw goes to the 1-inch line from the top, both side, and you kind of, you know, sandwich that bottom line, bottom fabric, like that, with the outer fabric and inner fabric, like that. And it's not nice and clean, but I'm gonna actually put the clip on for both side. Then I tried to fix everything, you know, nice and neat, smooth, the flat as much as possible. And zipper and tail, you tack it in as much as possible, this one too. Otherwise, you might sew, you know, the part of the zipper when you sew on the side. So make sure you don't sew on the zipper. Again, take your time. This is very important. Every alignment has to be matched. Now it's all good, but one more time, I just want to make sure the bottom has to match with the 1-inch line for both sides, okay? Because it has to be balanced, right? And the left side with the zipper tail, and the other side, which is right side, zipper starts. With the zipper start side, you can sew from top to down, 1/2-inch seam allowance, okay? Top down, because there's no end tail. And with the zipper end tail, you can only sew from the 1-inch line and down. That's the difference. There you go. I already saw them. You know the difference, right? Then now you turn the work inside out from the 4-inch opening on top of the zipper part. Slowly. Make sure everything is coming out, especially the zipper tail. And you put the hand in and push the corner out. I was supposed to cut the bottom corner to, you know, make the corner nice and clean, but I forgot. But it was actually okay. So there you go. So one side is now done. Okay, that's a mid pocket. And the other side is not done yet. So you have to do exactly same thing. But I think this one is easier, this side. Again, the other side, okay, that's attached, and the other side is not done yet. There's wide open on the side. Flip again. I didn't really have to fold anything because it was already attached to the other side of the fabric, right? So, doesn't mean, you know, you don't have to be very careful. You still have to be very careful with the zipper tail and that, you know, side of the pocket part. You can't really sew everything on, right? So again, the bottom goes to the one inch line from the top. This is pretty much for the alignment, right? You know, if one side is, you know, the one inch, the other side is, you know, the half inch, it doesn't, you know, look good. It's kind of awkward shape. So again, this is not nice and neat, but I'm gonna actually use the clip to keep the bottom at the 1 inch line. Then I'm gonna kind of, you know, fix everything nice and neat. And I leave the zipper tail out this time because it doesn't really matter, because I'm not gonna sew from top to down on the zipper inside, right? But you know, it was kind of hard to take that out later, so maybe you should tuck that in. There you go. Again, the zipper end sides you can't sew from top down. The other side you can sew from top down. Okay, you gotta remember that. And after that, you turn the work out. And on the video, I said actually I should have cut the corner. That's the, you know, the bottom corner. I should cut a little bit so it's gonna be nice and clean corner. But you know, it turned sort of okay without the cutting the corner. So it was all good. Anyway, so now I use my finger to push the every corner out and make sure nice and neat. Then it was kind of hard to take the zipper tail out because I didn't tuck that in. Anyway, so this side, the zipper end side, you gotta actually see after this. It's kind of coming out because I didn't sew, right? So you tuck those excessive fabric in nice and neat. Okay, nice and neat. Use the finger and push that in. Both sides. And then you will actually make the top stitch, the side, and along the zipper edge, because you have to close the opening, you know, for the inner layer side. So there you go, that's the side you have to close. So you have to do the top stitching, the side and top, like that for both sides. Okay, and that's about it. I just did the top stitching. There we go, nice and neat. Yeah, the zipper begin nice and clean. And that's the side, 2.5 inch. Do you remember you draw the line for the pocket? And bottom. And when you open, there's big enough pocket, two of them, and small pocket in the middle. And again, if you want to have a bigger pocket in the middle, that's fine, but make sure it's not too big. And if you want to have a gusset in a bottom corner, you can do that, but it's, you know, a little bit different than usual. So maybe next time I can show you how. And 9.5 inch wide, 9.5, and about 7 inches tall, the finished product measurement. Okay? And lastly, if you have the fabric with the only one direction, you have to do batting. Otherwise, the inside of the pocket, the design goes upside down. I did batting. That's why it's not upside down. And also, you can do round corner if you like. Okay? That's about it. Enjoy sewing!